So what are some of the other things that have been donated to you guys?
Clothing, cigarettes, occasionally money, shoes, rides. People ask what we need, and you know, we have simple little things. One lady came and said, do you guys need wet wipes? She bought up a whole bunch of wet wipes, paper towels, necessities.
Now, they said you get till 5 o'clock tomorrow.
5 o'clock tomorrow.
Do you guys all leave together? Or do you guys have like a game plan, or are you going to move to another?
Most people don't know yet.
Now, have you tried, I'm sure just like other people, have you tried like going out and applying for jobs and stuff like that?
I'm waiting on disability.
Okay. Well, I appreciate you guys letting us come out and take a little video. Now, if you had, you know, if you wanted to tell anybody out there, is there anything that you'd want to say?
If anybody's got private property, that some of these people could pitch a tent on. So like, it would be great. But we have to be off of public property by 5 o'clock tomorrow.
Is there anybody else that would like to say anything?
I really don't think this is fair because DOT let us come under here in the first place. And the minute it began to change and grow, everybody washed their hands of it. If they walked through this camp and saw what was really here, it's supplies that's needed for day-to-day life. It's not a junkyard. Sorry if they think it looks that way.
Yeah, because there was a local news that did a story about y'all, and that, you know, of course, you know, people were posting comments, and somebody said that, you know, there was broken down cars and you know,
and
beer cans
lived in
them,
and
like,
nobody lived in none of the cars.
Do you see beer cans?
No, I haven't seen it.
There's no drinking, no drugging under the bridge, and that has been since I've been under here before even the first tent went up.
Right.
Because I was here before the tents even began to show up. Cars were still parking in this parking lot. And I don't think what they're doing is fair. And the city's saying that they don't want anybody sleeping anywhere on public property between 6 p.m. and 6 a.m. Do you know what the plan is? Do you have any idea what the plan is? The plan is we sleep all day, walk the streets all night. That's our plan. You pass that law, that's how we're going to handle it. Come up with a solution, not just throw people away. I mean, there's grandparents out here. There's parents out here. Somebody's child is out here. And I'm not talking child, grown children. Give people a break.
Is there anybody else that'd like to voice their opinion? Yeah.
What is it with the city? Do they not even give a damn that we're dispersing now? This was my safety right here. I am a lone female. I've been raped twice since I've been homeless because I wasn't under this bridge, and now you're sending me away from the bridge again? This is not fair. When I first started camping out under this bridge 2 years and 2 months ago, Bay City bought me my first tent.
You feel protected here?
Absolutely, I do.
I do too. There's safety in numbers. That's why there's so many women under.
See, I'm from Tennessee. I'm one of those old country boys. You protect your women. You do everything you can to protect them. And I'll go to prison over these women under here. If I catch somebody messing with them, I'm gonna hurt him. I'm gonna hurt him bad. I've already broke one guy's jaw over a woman, and I'll do it again. Now, I'm not ashamed to say I'll fight for these women.
All these people that are throwing us away, city commissioner, or city commission and all this, I want them to stop and think, how would they feel if their mother was in this tent city? How would they feel? What would they do for their mother? Stop and think of it that way. We're not trash under here. We are people down on our luck. We don't do drugs under here. We don't get drunk under here. I even heard a rumor that there was a prostitution ring working out of here.
Yeah,
and that's a lot of crap.
Everybody is just one paycheck away from being exactly where we're at right now.
Get down on your health. Company goes out of business. Then what are you going to do? Obviously, the city of Emerald is not going to help you. 3-year waiting list for HUD. Shelters are full. Now what do you do? So, we have all decided, and I don't know about under Tent City, but all the other homeless that walk the streets, we have all decided. You can't sleep from 6 p.m. to 6 a.m.? Fine, we'll walk the streets in, we'll sleep all day, and we'll sleep right down there on City Hall lawn.
Are they more concerned about how their precious little city works than
whether or not they're helping everybody?
You see an iceberg, you see 10%. We're just 10% of the iceberg, people. Okay?
No, all they want to do is think about money. Well, if they give us a chance to prove ourselves, give us jobs, where we get up off the streets, we would be productive citizens.
Even a mediator between some of the homeless and employers that would help the homeless person work something out with somebody that's going to hire them. Because I'm going to tell you what, you would not believe how many people promise jobs every single day to a homeless person and then screw them out of their money or pay them slave wages. It's cradles. There are panhandlers out there, but the people that stay under this bridge, I've never seen one of them fly a sign, beg for money. No. If we need to borrow something, we borrow from each other. We leave John Q. Public out of it.
And it should be better on the city to have us all in one spot, don't you think?
So you think that they should provide a part of land for you guys to come in?
That'd be cool.
Absolutely. For 30 years, I paid taxes in
this
town.
To put our tents on, we would be fine.
I've been in this city since I was 18 months old.
We've been accused of having appliances, too.
I'm not seeing appliances.
You couldn't plug anything in if you wanted to.
And it never feels out of place. And you're still probably.